few hours' peace in a life eaten up by worry. That's all I ask for. But they would rather see me gone. I dare to think the association had wearied, were drained of all excuses to bury me. That was enough to spark a fresh fuse. A bomb under my bed? But what miserly firebrands. But though I survive defeated. Now I must limp to the wilderness to lick my wounds. The Rue Saint-Georges will rattle soon with carts dragging away their spoils. They fail to kill me with rumour and threat, then blade and bomb, and succeed with a simple trepanation. Relentless perjury, their sawing drill. My bones, my money, worn to dust. A long, long campaign. The courts of France more often my lodgings than here. More victories than defeats. But they knew all the while they would drain me. Again. Bankrupt. And no hope this time of an emperor's perfumed hand searching for mine in the mire.
No more create a demon now in his wasting years than could a hollow tree bear fruit. There was a time when Emperor Napoleon III would play handsel giver and keep creditors at bay. No more. This time, the factory is closed, its giblets scooped and shared among the enemy's pots. Was he free of blame? He could stoop too. He wasn't above prigging valve schemes from the unwitting. Adolf Sachs, casual thiever of ideas. But let anyone take their chance with him and spew Enter's money into the bottomless pit of legal process.
What do you say? What unearthly rantings are these?
And if he hadn't bound me so tight from birth, I may have had a more fruitful growth.
I held you tight, yes. Could have let you fly, but what would have become of you?
I may have soared clear of the jealousy and the petty pilfering and the nipping and plucking at me by those you made your enemies.
I protected you with patents to plan and
to make
plan
money.
And steer your course, to make certain your proper reception by proper musicians, a sentinel against those who heard you as nothing less than a bastard banshee, and to prosper, yes, to prosper, and what of it?
You are no richer now than when you arrived in Paris.
When I hear your shrill voice reproaching, in my mind, I recall our ride in triumph on the Champ de Mars. Is it not brave of you to cast down yet another gauntlet, a familial joust more wretched by far?
Had you been born with humility, you may have had sufficient in your purse And I, the embraces of men, the length and breadth of the empire.
No, I would be no more than a turner, engraver, a smelter of brass. Your doppelgangers would squeak and squeal with 100,000 anonymous voices. You, my dear, would be dead.
With your other flights of fancy.
What?
Your saxo thunder, your saxo cannon, your saxo...
None of them flights of fancy.
An organ blasted through the land, pumped by a steam train.
It would have scattered such beauty of sound.
The sheet, more like.
My chance to broadcast to an entire population.
Neither you nor I will ever broadcast. Our throats are cut.
And you charge me with honing the blade?
Yes. All the while I cowered from the knocking on the door when the true threat shivered beside me, cloying and covetous. Oh, you thought you'd forged a mistress. Your jealousy gripped me and made fearful what could have been a welcoming world.
You are no mistress?
I think I'm but a brassy whore.
And I have slipped all my money, year upon year, neath your pillow for nothing but your seductive, gasping sounds and my ruin.
Yes.
And if I had not protected you, if I had tarted you up and given you over, the hands of those who became my enemies would have what, caressed? Cleaved, suffocated, killed?
Oh, I'd rather have taken my chances.
Why?
Well, here I am, with friends, yes, a handful, but impotent. And I have no future. I mean, you no longer teach, so few know all my tricks. You're destitute. I have no power. We're dying.
Consider one thing.
Yes?
I never wanted you to be prostrated by fumbling hands. When I had youth, I had spirit. That spirit you leached and reshaped as power. Your power can garrote any man without sense, any score without depth. Though I was spent, I had to keep hope.
You were afraid of me.
I am afraid. We were doomed to suffer. We won't live.
Thank you.
And I'm still here. He died in his 80th year. Poor, hated, loved. I'm still here. He died in the year 4,000 craftsmen in Chicago lost their work. In Germany, an engine was conceived. In Britain, a former prime minister resigned, a future statesman born. The key players in these acts? Pullman, Diesel, Gladstone, Belisha. Carriages, cars, bags, beacons. It was an age when pride was taken in a family name, honour in its deathlessness. And so, Saks, I'm still here. How? Because I learned, after he'd gone, that his holding on had fettered the dark demon in me. And when he took those rare chances to release me, it was his golden demon that burst free. His incandescent, pyrotechnic, mayfly demon. He knew short blasts of brilliance were better than an epidemic droning. I know now, too. I learned my lesson on my own, in the hands of bottom-of-the-bill vaudevillians. A mechanical novelty alongside ocarina and ukulele. Then I learned how to strike fear again by corrupting youth and insinuating my way into the grasp of those who, and Adolf would have loved this, those who were true musicians. I'm still here. Saks saved me, after all. He warded off my every temptation to remain an earthbound instrument. Magical. Mystical. His child lives.